In this example, we're going to evaluate the integral of x squared times cosine of x dx. So let's think about what integration technique would be helpful to use in this situation. So often U substitution is going to be the first thing we consider. It's one of the first techniques that we learned how to do. But if I glance at this integral, it doesn't look like U substitution is going to be helpful for me. I don't see any quantity U whose derivative du also appears in the expression. Okay, so U substitution then, not going to work here. So then maybe another thing we would consider trying is this new method we've learned called integration by parts. So integration by parts says that the integral of u dv equals uv minus the integral of v du. And we've already done several examples with integration by parts so far. So let's try integration by parts and see if it's helpful in this situation. So to do integration by parts, the first step is just to pick what I want u to be and what I want dv to be. And then from those quantities, I'll compute du and v. Okay, so when you're choosing u and dv, there's no set rules to this. Every problem's a little different, but there's some things that are true in a lot of situations. And often, if you have any sort of algebraic or polynomial expression, so here I'm looking at this x squared piece, any powers of x, often that's going to be a good choice for u. So let's try letting u equal x squared. Well, if u equals x squared, then dv must be cosine of x dx. That's all that's left. Now, another thing we want to keep in mind when we're picking u and dv is that we want to make sure our dv is a quantity that we're able to integrate. And in this case, it is. We're able to integrate cosine of x dx. So then let's go ahead and continue. As our next steps, we'll go ahead and compute du and v. So I compute du by taking the derivative of u. Okay, so that's going to give me 2x dx in this case. And then I compute v by integrating cosine of x dx. And that's going to give me sine of x. Plus c technically, but we'll include the plus c in our final answer. So now that I have this, I can go ahead and apply my formula. So I can say that the integral of x squared cosine x dx equals uv. Okay, so for me that's x squared sine x minus the integral of v du, which here is 2x sine of x dx. Okay, so the goal here with integration by parts is to obviously help me evaluate this integral. So I would hope that either one, this new integral I get would be something that I could evaluate just right off the bat. Or secondly, if I can't evaluate it right off the bat, that it's at least more simple than what I started with. So here in my new expression, I see that I have the integral of 2x sine of x. And that's not something I'm just going to be able to evaluate with a basic antiderivative formula, but it is simpler than what I've started with, right? I've reduced my power of x from an x squared to just an x to the first power here. So this is actually an improvement. But we're not done yet because we do need to evaluate this integral to finish out the problem. So how do we proceed from here? Well, we just proceed as we would in any other situation. Now I've got this integral 2x sine of x. I want to think, okay, how do I evaluate this integral? And this integral also looks like it would be a good candidate for integration by parts. Now, we've seen integrals like this before. And this is pretty common, that you would have to do integration by parts several times in order to complete a problem. So then let's just look at this integral here, 2x sine of x, and try to use integration by parts on that. So if I do that, I'm going to let u equal 2x, once again, this algebraic or polynomial expression, and I'm going to let dv equal sine of x dx. So then my du is going to be 2 dx, and my v is going to be negative cosine of x. All right, so then I'm just going to apply integration by parts again. I'm going to leave this x squared sine of x and then minus out front. Now, you want to be a little careful and maybe bracket this off so that you do remember to distribute that subtraction sign. And then within these brackets, I'm going to apply my integration by parts formula to this integral here. So I should get uv, so that's minus 2x cosine of x, and then minus the integral of v du. So here this is going to be minus a negative, so plus the integral of 2 cosine of x dx. And now that's an integral that I can just directly evaluate. Okay, so going through with this, I'm going to have x squared sine of x, and then minus, and in my brackets here I have negative 2x cosine of x plus, okay, and then the integral of cosine, once again a sine, so this is going to give me plus 2 sine of x, and then plus my constant of integration. Last of all, I'll just go ahead and distribute the subtraction sign. So my final answer then is x squared sine of x plus 2x cosine of x minus 2 sine of x, and then plus c. I can write plus c or minus c. It doesn't really matter since it's just a constant of integration. In this example, we're going to evaluate the integral of e to the x times sine of x dx. Now, first of all, let's note that this does not look like it's going to be a good candidate for u substitution. So, instead, let's try integration by parts and see if that will help us solve this or evaluate this integral. So, my integration by parts formula is that the integral of u dv equals uv minus the integral of v du. So, I need to start by identifying what I want u to be and what I want dv to be. Now for this particular example, there's really no obvious choice for u and for dv. I don't see any powers of x here, and I can integrate both of these parts, so either one would be fine as dv. And actually, really in this problem, it's going to work out either way we do it. So let's just try then letting u equal e to the x, and we'll let dv then equal sine of x dx. Okay, so from here I want to compute du. So if I take the derivative of e to the x, I'm going to get e to the x and then a dx. And then I can compute v by integrating dv. Okay, and that's going to give me negative cosine of x. Okay, so then I'm going to apply my integration by parts formula. So my original integral then is equal to uv, so here that's negative e to the x cosine of x, minus the integral of v du. Now notice here, when I do minus this integral, I'm going to get minus a negative, so I'm just going to go ahead and make this a plus. Plus e to the x cosine of x dx. Okay, so what do I have here? Well, I have this new expression that contains a new integral, the integral of e to the x cosine of x dx. Now, this is not a simple integral. It's not something I can just write down the answer to, unfortunately. Now, what we like to see in integration by parts is we like to see things get simpler, right, as we go through these iterations of integration by parts. And sometimes we will have to do it multiple times, but still we'd like to see things get simpler as we go through the process. Now, in my case, things haven't really gotten simpler, but they haven't gotten more complicated either, right? I really have a very similar expression as I did in the first step. I've just replaced sine of x with cosine of x. So let's just try doing integration by parts one more time, just to see what happens. Okay, so I'm going to do now integration by parts on this new integral. And I'm going to choose the same parts. So I'm going to let u equal e to the x. And here dv then would be cosine of x dx. So then going from there, for my du, I get e to the x dx. And for my v, if I integrate cosine, I am just going to get sine of x. Okay, so then I'm going to keep this first term here, this negative e to the x cosine of x, plus, and then I'm going to replace this integral, the integral of e to the x cosine x, by this integration by parts formula. So uv, so plus e to the x sine of x, minus the integral of v du. So minus the integral of e to the x sine x dx. Okay, so those terms there are just replacing that second integral. Okay, so what do I see now? Well, I've gone through this process again, and so I have more terms, and I have this new integral. But this new integral, the integral of e to the x sine x dx, is actually the original integral that I started with. So this is kind of strange, but it makes sense if we consider the pieces that are making up this integral, right? I've got this e to the x, and no matter how many times I take the derivative or integrate e to the x, I'm always going to get e to the x back out. And then I've got this sine of x, which if I take its derivative or integral, I'm going to cycle through sines and cosines and just keep going back and forth. So it kind of makes sense that this would be cyclic and that I would get back to my original integral. Okay, so that maybe makes sense, but is it something we can work with? Well, this whole expression right here is equal to this original integral. So what I can do is I can be a little clever. Okay, so what I'm actually going to do here, notice that I have this integral of e to the x sine x on both the left and the right hand side. I'm going to combine those. I'm going to actually add to both sides of my equation the integral of e to the x sine x dx. So if I follow through with that, on the left-hand side, I get two integrals of e to the x sine of x dx equals, and then on the right, I have my negative e to the x cosine of x plus e to the x sine x. Now, what I'm actually trying to do, if you recall, is I'm trying to evaluate this integral here. So then to isolate that integral, I'm going to divide both sides by this factor of 2. And so what I get is that the integral of e to the x sine of x equals negative e to the x cosine of x plus e to the x sine of x all over 2. And since we haven't done so up to this point, we do just need to add a constant of integration. And this is actually our answer. We found an expression for this integral. So this is a pretty cool example, a pretty cool and classic example of having to use integration by parts multiple times to evaluate an integral.